Okay, so now let's go ahead and perform a bat character identification. So what exactly is a bat character? So any unwanted character that can break the shell code are considered to be bat character. So when you send a particular payload, it will be consisting of different characters. Now you don't want that your payload doesn't run successfully simply because your program doesn't accept some of the characters. Now those character which is not been accepted by program will be known as your bat character. So in order to identify the bat character, we are going to send the full list of character that is starting from your 0x00 to 0xff, right? All the hexadecimal character and see which character is been accepted by your program or not. So we can view all those character inside the stack memory area by dumping the memory and analyze what is been accepted and what is not. So let's go ahead and run our program and modify to send all this character, right? So I'll just simply show you. You can either Google it or you can directly get it from one of the Kali Linux tool also. So if I paste, which I have just copy pasted. So these are the list of all hexadecimal characters starting from 00 to slash XFF, right? So now let's go ahead and create a variable name as bat character, right? And equal to, I will say these characters, right? So I've just simply copy pasted all this bat character right here. Now next, what I'm going to so modify my program. So after B, you can send all this bat character, right? So that our program in we can analyze better in our dump area or memory area. So I'll simply save this program, come out of it, and since I have already attached my Immunity Debugger to my program, so I will simply go ahead and run this script against our target. As soon as I run it, it should crash. Yeah, it has crashed and our EIP is overwritten with 4242. And next, what we are going to see, we want to see the ESP or stack memory, right? So we can directly right click on it and see follow in dump. Now, okay, so I guess we didn't click properly, so we can click again ESP and I can say follow in dump. We can either follow in stack also. Now, if you see in follow in dump, you could see that our register has been filled with A and B, B, B later, and after that, it is containing all the hexadecimal character. Now we can verify simply which character has been accepted or not by checking the flow that we have sent it. So if you see here in our program, we have sent first 00, then 01. So the dump memory should also contain 0001 sequence, right? But over here, you could see it starts with 0A and then 00003 09B, like that way. So that means our first character, that is 00, is not been accepted. So let's do one thing. Let's go to our program and remove that 00 and then send the specific payload again. So this way you have to repeatedly send it again and again. Also make a note of the like the bat character. You can make simply like hash bat character, right, equal to slash, I can mention slash x 00, right? So now I will send it again and see how our program is behaving. So I will again go to debug, restart it, right, and allow the program to run. So this is the way same step you have to follow multiple time in order or till you get all this character has been accepted by your program in a proper fashion, right? Or all the hexadecimal character. If you see a flow break in the sequence, then you identify that as in a bad character, character previous to that. Now again, it has overwritten, so I will simply click on ESP and say follow in dump, right? Again, here you can see it is now following the right sequence, so it is sending like 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07, 08, right? So if you look at our program also, you are sending 01, 02, 03, 04, 05. That way our sequence is correct. Now let's see where exactly it is stopping, right? So 06, 07, 80, yeah, 09 is again not here. I couldn't see anywhere. So I will again remove 09 and send the same script again. So let me go to the script. So I will say 09 to be removed from here and add it here, right? Comma slash x 09 and save it again. So again, I will come out and restart the program. okay, so the program is running again. I have to click on run. It should ask me IP address again. Okay, let me specify the IP address. So this is the most crucial part where you have to repeatedly do the bad character hunting by sending the same payload again and again, or by simply removing his character and then sending again and again. Okay, so it should crash again. Now it has crashed and EIP overwritten with 42. Let's go ahead and check with ESP and dump, follow the in the dump. So you could see here the sequence again: 0102, 03, 05, 07, 08, 09 is not there. So 0A is next as per our likelihood. If you again go and see here, I have copied here, so it is better, right? So 09 is not there. So we have using 0A, 0B. That way you go ahead and see. So 0A, 0B, it is there already, right? 0C, 0A. Again, so 0D is another bad character, right? So this way you keep on following till you find out a clean sequence. So I will do this and finally show you what are the bad characters that I have enumerated. Typically, it will be 4 to 5 max.